glad you're joining us again today at weekdaychurch.com. I'm really excited about, as we're going through this week of questions that people often ask, does the Bible talk about these things? On Monday, we talked about interracial marriage. Does the Bible say that we shouldn't marry people of other races? If you didn't watch that one, I encourage you to go back and watch Mondays. Yesterday, we talked about what happens when I die. I mean, immediately when I die, what happens? On Wednesday, today, we're talking about, are dinosaurs in the Bible? On Thursday, tomorrow, do I have a destiny? Or is my life just sort of floating by? And on Friday, what works must I do to be saved? These are questions Christians are asked, pastors especially, are asked a lot of the time, and that's what we're going to be answering this week. Today should be a really fun one, actually. Are dinosaurs in the Bible? If not, why not? I mean, you know, I mean, this is a big deal. Did they not know about them? And if so, well, how? I don't ever remember reading the word dinosaur in the Bible. Well, that's what we're going to be talking about today. Hope you stick around for it. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for Jesus. Thank you that we can be saved. Thank you for your word that guides us in the truth. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Now, as we're talking about our dinosaurs in the Bible, I think the most important thing to understand is the word dinosaur isn't going to be in the Bible. Because the word dinosaur didn't come out until around the early 1800s that people started using the word dinosaur. There were other words used for things that we call dinosaurs today. Let's just be real specific. There are many words used for dinosaurs today if you're not using the word dinosaur, but you're going to be specific. Tyrannosaurus rex or brontosaurus or pterodactyl or things like that. You say, well, okay, fine. Then they weren't called dinosaurs. Did they go by other names? If it wasn't called, well, that's what we're going to be looking at today. If you look in the Bible, do you see things that are pretty much what we would call dinosaurs today that were maybe called different names? You say, how would that even be the case? If they died 165 million years ago and there were no men till like 100,000 years ago, they never were together. I mean, unless they were a whole bunch of archaeologists, how would they have known? Well, the question is this. What if they didn't? What if men and dinosaurs were here at the same time? And I understand that's a young earth creationist point of view. I get that. But what if they were? What would people have called them? What would we have seen if we lived at the same time as the dinosaurs? How would you have described them? Well, let's turn to the book of Job, chapter 40, and we'll start in verse 15, and we'll see what it says. Behold, behemoth. This is God speaking to Job. Which I made as I made you. He eats grass like an ox. Behold, his strength in his loins, and his power in the muscle of his belly. He makes his tail stiff like a cedar. The sinews of his thighs are knit together. His bones are tubes of bronze. His limbs like bars of iron. He is the first of the works of God. Let him who made him bring near his sword, for the mountains yield food for him where all the wild beasts play. Under the lotus plants he lies, in the shelter of the reeds and in the marsh. For his shade the lotus trees cover him, the willows of the brook surround him. Behold, if the river is turbulent, he is not frightened. He is confident, though Jordan rushes against his mouth. Can one take him by the eyes or pierce his nose with the snare? It talks about a second one in the next chapter. Can you draw out Leviathan with a fish hook, or press down his tongue with a cord? Can you put a rope in his nose, or pierce his jaw with a hook? Will he make many pleas to you? Will he speak to you with soft words? Will he make a covenant with you to take him as your servant forever? And they go on talking about this. It says that he's got scales that overlap, and you can't get through them. You know, it's amazing, all the way into the 14th and 15th centuries, people and cultures throughout the world are talking about what we call dinosaurs today as dragons. They often look different. Sometimes they're in the water, as you see here. Sometimes they're on the land. Sometimes they can do both, go on the water and the land. They're enormous and as big as the dinosaurs that we talk about. Now, I know some dinosaurs are small and some are big, but we aren't normally thinking of the small ones and we say, why didn't they talk about them? We're normally thinking of the big ones. I mean, when you hear these things, that's not an elephant who's that big. and has a tail like a cedar. An elephant has a little tiny tail like a dog or something. I mean, impressive tail, you know. And can you fight against this thing? Hardly. It sure wouldn't be easy. Are you crazy? It's one of God's most impressive things. And he goes, you know, I created this same as I created you. Job, are you sure about that? What about the Leviathan? And if you read carefully through chapter 41, what you see is it's not just going to be a reptile that's going to be a lot like an alligator. This is something much more massive, much stronger than an alligator, as hard as it is to do that. There are people who actually just go wrestle alligators with their bare hands. No, this was something that said, you're not going to mess with this thing. And when you think of some of the, you know, ocean-going creatures that were so impressive, and we talk about these, but we don't know. And you say, would you have gone against that and tried to get in your boat? There are some that if you just had a wooden boat out there, would drag your boat down. That's that strong. You know, you think, what would you do? There were things in the Bible, and this is not the only passages that talk about it, about behemoth and leviathan and about dragons, and this is not the only culture in the world that talks about it. Besides, Job wasn't a Jew. This wasn't just a Jewish culture thing. Job was not a Jew. You say, well, I'd really like some more information on this, and I sure can't give it in a 15-minute video. I don't even talk for most of it. There's the songs and other things. So as you look at this and you say, well, you know, is there more info? If you're seriously wanting to look into this and see a different point of view, I'm not saying proof, but I'm saying something else, an alternate point of view. I'm going to ask you to go to two different places. They'll be on there, so you can read them and write them down. Answers in Genesis. That's one of them. Answers in Genesis. The other one is the Creation Research Institute. Creation Research Institute. I'd ask you to look these up with an open mind, looking into these things and seeing what they are. If you're like me, you can have a pretty good understanding of some of the philosophies and stuff behind it, but maybe you're not a scientist, or maybe you are. Maybe you've got a pretty good scientific mind. You've studied a lot of that. And I think if you did, they've got many scientists and doctorates there who can get into some of the, even the very deep stuff of genetics and so forth, and I think you'd find it fascinating. But the neat thing is the Bible does talk about this. And if you want a lot more detail, I encourage you to go to these sites to see what it says. We're going to close with a really fun song by Stephen Curtis Chapman. It's called Dancing with the Dinosaurs. My fondest memories of this song are when I was a children's minister of the little kindergartners through fifth graders, and we would sing this song, and you'd have a whole bunch of little kids trying to look like a dinosaur in the cutest way they possibly could, and it was pretty cute. So have a wonderful rest of your day. Thanks for joining us. I'll see you again tomorrow. We'll find